It was no surprise when a 15-month-old female bear anxiously dashed into the Tulare County wilderness when the cage door was lifted. This young black bear and another yearling released at about the same time in Mono County began the long day hundreds of miles to the south at a wildlife rehab facility near San Diego. The two orphan bears were brought to the Ramona Wildlife Center early in the year. It's believed one lost its mother in a car collision, while the other was apparently left alone after heavy winter rains flooded a den. For 5 months, the staff at Ramona was careful to feed and care for the cubs while keeping as much distance as possible so the animals wouldn't learn to rely on humans for survival.
They're very, very smart. Bears are probably our most challenging animals to keep here, to keep them wild. They come to us sometimes acclimated already, and our goal is to turn them around and get them wild again.
On the day of the release, the bears were chemically immobilized for two reasons: so they could be examined, weighed, and measured one last time by a fish and wildlife biologist. Also, so ear tags and GPS collars could be attached. CDFW is currently tracking bears, mountain lions, deer, and other species that have been in department care to learn what we can about their survival, their travels, and habitat use. We're also evaluating the outcome of management actions that relied on GPS data. This year marks the first time all releasable bears that have spent time in rehab will be tracked systematically following that release.
Our goal with these collars is to track the outcomes of those animals, to try to learn about what proportion of them under the current conditions are succeeding, and what can we learn about how to be most effective with rehabilitation of orphan black bears.
Ryan Leahy is the department's statewide wildlife conflict specialist, working with a team of nearly 20 that respond to the increasing number of calls from communities that share space with black bear, mountain lion, coyote, and other native wildlife. CDFW provides technical assistance about human-wildlife interactions, as well as options for safe coexistence to these communities, neighborhoods, and people throughout the state. Collars on animals are a valuable tool in this work. These bear collars are programmed to automatically drop off the animal after 9 months, then they're retrieved.
Most important thing we want to identify is, do they survive? How do they do in the wild? Do they thrive? That young animal that comes in with almost no experience gained from the mother, almost no overlap, does that animal have the same degree or chance of success as an animal that comes in at 6 months old, maybe a little bit bigger, a little healthier, a little more experience? And how does it do when compared to one that comes in at 9 or 10 months in, that's been with the mother, with the female bear for all of that time? Success in the wild is they found a home range, they've got great habitat, they're not involved in conflict, and they're out in the woods. Every 2 hours, it'll take a fix. If you get four of those fixes, it's an exact location of that animal's current position at that time.
Good girl.
CDFW doesn't just track wildlife with collars for research purposes. The department might also move quickly to intercept that animal to discourage that community visit.
If we believe the animal is starting to trend or approach a community, we'll utilize this information to try to beat the animal to that spot, to either apply hazing or negative conditioning techniques, non-lethal techniques, to push that animal and persuade that animal away from that attractant or that home.
The department has taken in 32 orphaned or injured bears this year from around the state. 20 were in good enough condition to be considered releasable back into the wild. 2 bears were permanently placed at a zoo in Eureka. The rest were unfortunately euthanized for animal welfare concerns, or they died in the early stages of care. On that day, the cubs were loaded into trucks near San Diego for the long trips back to where they were found. One traveled 270 miles, the other 400. And those travels continue, something we know because of collars sending signals to satellites, which then bounce that information back down to department computers.
They're still out there moving around. This one got pretty close to the highway, but as of today, I don't see this animal getting anywhere near development. It's taken a pretty long walk. That bear's doing quite well.